Now we chapter 12, linear programming. So linear programming is a programming to solve a particular situation, hypothetical or a real life situation. This has many applications in the real life situation. So the program consists of certain functional expression, and this functional expression will contain certain variables. So variables means this variable can vary its values, varies. And there may be restrictions for the variation of the variables. And in that case, what can be the functional value and so on, that we want to discuss in this. Actually, this discussion is based on optimizing the function, optimizing the functional expression, or we want to optimize certain functional expression involving certain number of variables. You have seen in earlier classes the equations, inequalities, equations involving number of variables, a single variable, say x alone, two variables, x and y, and so we can have equations or inequalities involving three or more variables also. You have seen the equations and the inequations up to a maximum of three variables. And we have the function connecting these variables, and we have to optimize this. Optimize means either maximize or minimize. That is, we want to find the possible values to optimize this, either maximize the function or minimize the function. So this is what we discuss in this chapter. Actually, maximize or minimize means we find the maximum value or minimum value with all the restrictions or constraints of these variables. We can have a explain with examples. So suppose we have an expression containing two variables x and y, say x plus y. Two variables containing x and y. And suppose we denote this y is under. Or we can take this as fxy or any expression we can write. So z equal to fxy. This x and y are variables, can vary. Suppose this x element of R, real numbers, y element of R. This R is set of R, real numbers, it varies from minus infinity to plus infinity. Suppose we first know, introduce any restriction for this x and y. Then, suppose we want to find the maximum value. Optimizing means either maximizing or minimizing. Suppose we want to maximize the system, the value of this. The value of z is x plus y, and when x equal to say 10, y equal to 20, then the value of this is 10 plus 20, which is 30. So for different values of x and y, we will have different values for this z. And all these values are solutions for this x. What is the maximum value? In the set of solutions, we have several solutions. For different values of x and y, we get different solutions. So what is the maximum value possible? or what is the minimum value possible. So the maximum value possible is denoted by maximum is no restriction for x and y, and therefore x can take the maximum value of r infinity, y can also take the maximum value of this r which is infinity. So x plus y is always therefore infinity. The maximum value of z is equal to infinity. What is the minimum value? The minimum value x can take is minus infinity, and for y is also minus infinity, and this minimum value of z, this minimum value of z is minus infinity. Very, very simple situation we discuss. And now suppose we impose restrictions on this x and y. X element of r, y element of r, and also suppose this x greater than or equal to 0, y greater than or equal to 0. Then, what is the maximum value of z? Maximum value of z is x greater than or equal to 0. X can take plus infinity, y also can take plus infinity, so maximum x plus y is again infinity. What is the minimum value possible? X can have the minimum value 0, y can have the minimum value 0. So the minimum value of the sum is 0. Change the minus infinity to 0 because of this restriction. And also suppose x greater than or equal to 0, y greater than or equal to 0, and also we see that this x less than or equal to 50 and y less than or equal to 40. Y less than or equal to 40. So what is the maximum and what is the minimum? In this we can see that this x can take a maximum 50 and y can take a maximum 40. So in the sum, the maximum is obtained when x is maximum and y is maximum. That may not be the case always. Always. So here the maximum is obtained when x is 50 and y is 40, and therefore the maximum value is 90 and the minimum value again 0. When restrictions increase, the value also correspondingly changing, increasing or decreasing in that way. And these are all simple situations, and therefore we can see that the maximum value of x, y, or the values of this x and y giving this, for making this maximum, for making that is a minimum, we can easily say. This may not be the case always. We may not be able to say specifically what can be the value of x, what can be the value of y in all the situations. Suppose we introduce another restriction for this x and y. So x to y element of r, and suppose 2 times x plus 3 times y less than or equal to 100, 3 times x minus 5 times y less than or equal to say 50. X, y greater than or equal to 0. This x and y have certain restrictions, and this is the restriction. This is the restriction. 2x plus 3 times y should be less than or equal to 100. No other option. Also 3x minus 5y, this also should be satisfied. 3 times x minus 5 times y should be less than or equal to 50. Both these two should be satisfied. This also satisfied. Should be satisfied. What can be the possible values of x and y which will make this maximum? No. Not so easy to say at once. So we have a definite specific method to find the values. Finding that values is called the solution, the solving the problem. This is a programming problem. We have a certain program. The program is to maximize this with these conditions. These conditions are constraints, restrictions of this X and Y. With these restrictions or constraints, what can be the possible values of X and Y which gives this function? This is called the objective function, because our objective is to maximize that or minimize that. That function, objective function. So the objective function together with all these constraints is our program. To maximize the objective function or minimize the objective function. So generally we can say to optimize the objective function with the constraints. This is the program. Depending upon the nature of the variables in the program, we define this program linear or non-linear. If the maximum power degree exponent of the variables in this is 1, first degree 1, it is called a linear program, otherwise non-linear. Higher degree, then it is non-linear. So this is linear, first degree, x, y, first degree, all the variables in this. There are two variables and in all the constraints and this objective function, the maximum power is 1. The greatest power is exponent is 1. So linear. So linear programming. And this is a problem we are facing. So it is called a linear programming problem, LPP, linear programming problem. Solving this is called the optimizing this problem. The solution is called the optimum value, either maximum or minimum. So here this X and Y we have taken hypothetically. This X and Y are variables and their constraints are this. So we have the objective function and we have method to solve this. So various methods to solve this situation, this problem. One such method is solving by graphical method. Graphical method, you can use graph, drawing the graph. We discuss this graphical method here. No other methods. Graphical solution. So we can have a situation in the real life. Suppose we want to make two types of cakes, cake food. So one type of cake needs say 300 grams of flour and say 100 grams of fat. Type 1 cake. And for type 2 cake we need 200 grams of flour and say 50 grams of fat. And we have 10 kilograms of flour and 2 kilograms of fat. What will be the number of cakes we can make so that the total number of cakes is maximum? Total number of cakes, the number, the count. What is the total number of cakes is maximum? We are interested in the number of cakes. What will be the total number of cakes? It's a real life problem. So first we want to make it's in terms of mathematical expressions, the objective function and the constraints. And that is called the mathematical formulation of the problem. Convert it into mathematical expressions, mathematical formulation. So first identify the objective function. For this, fix the variables. Variables are the variables we want to find, the number of cakes, total number of cakes. How many number of type 1 cake and how many number of type 2 cake. Then we can find these values so that the total number is maximum. Suppose x is the number of type 1 cakes and y is the number of type 2 cakes. Then objective function is clearly x plus y. Total number of cakes. Total number of cakes. Okay? And now the restrictions. For type 1 cake, 300 grams of flour and 100 grams of fat. For type 2, 200 grams of flour and 50 grams of fat. Available flour is 10 kilogram and fat 2 kilogram. That means for x number of cakes we need 300 into x grams of flour, and for y 200 grams of flour. So we see that 300x plus 200y less than or equal to 5 kilogram, 10 kilograms, that is 10,000 grams. Maximum 10 kilogram flour available. 200 into x plus 300 into x plus 200 into y less than or equal to this. And for the case of this fat, 100 grams for type 1, so 100x plus 50 grams for the second, 50y less than or equal to available 200 kilograms, 2 kilograms, so 2000 grams, 2000, and x, y both greater than or equal to 0. So this subjective function with this constraint. So mathematically formulated, mathematical formulation, and this is linear, first degree in exam, so this is a linear programming problem. Optimize the subjective function, find the maximum number of cakes, so that find the maximum or the possible value of x and possible value of y, so that the sum is maximum. So such situations we deal here in the linear programming problem, or in this chapter linear programming. So details, more details in the next video. Okay?